थैंक यू वैभव. आई बीन सॉर्ट ऑफ इन अ प्रिविलेज पोजिशन बिकॉज मैं कल भी यहाँ पे थी और बहुत कुछ सुना. आज सुबह एक बहुत अच्छा समराइजेशन भी हुआ कि क्या क्या बातचीत हुई दो दिनों में. हमारे पास आज यहाँ पे बड़े लीडर्स हैं और चर्चा ये हो रही है कि हम आगे कैसे बढ़े. हमने बहुत सारी बातें सुनी, चैलेंजेस सुने. पिछले सेशन में पूरा उसको समराइज़ करके बताया गया कि क्या क्या इश्यूज़ इमर्ज हुए लास्ट दो दिन की बातचीत में. तो सबसे पहले मैं तपन सेन जी से रिक्वेस्ट करूँगी कि उन्होंने सुना सुबह की बात जो चर्चाएं दो दिन में चली, उनका क्या विचार है कि हमें आगे कैसे बढ़ना चाहिए. हाउ शुड वी मूव फॉरवर्ड गिवन सो मेनी इश्यूज एंड चैलेंजेस दैट वी हैव बीन फेसिंग इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ लेबर मूवमेंट इन इंडिया, ऑफ द पॉलिटिकल एंड यू नो नॉट गेटिंग डिवाइडेड ऑन द इश्यूज ऑफ कास्ट क्लास एंड दैट्स एंड वी नीड टू बी इन द पॉलिसी मेकिंग पोजिशंस टू एक्चुअली मेक दोज चेंजेस एंड गेट अ प्रो वर्कर रिजीम बिकॉज वी आर नॉट देयर, देयरफॉर दोज थिंग्स डू हैपन. You also talked about how the trade union movement is growing, but at the same time, it does remain divided. So we need to be on the common platform, at least on certain agendas. Also, you talked about how there is actually a role of the employers also, and a healthy workforce represent a healthy and competitive businesses, and that's how the country can grow. So how do we get the employers into this whole discussion on actually having a progressive regime? And you also talked about the new evidence which is being created to actually undermine what has been done earlier, and therefore the trade unions, academia, the workers organizations need to be very conscious of these new changes that are coming up and actually work in coordination to understand what these changes are and how to strategize and put forward a common viewpoint in front of the government. Thank you so much for that. I would now I think I've the points that I wanted to make as a speaker in terms of way forward, and many things have already been said, but I mean, being the only woman in the panel, I wanted to bring attention to the value of women's work and how it's very important to include women in this whole struggle, whether it is domestic workers or whether it's, we had the discussion yesterday on sex workers and Bar Girls Union. I think it's very important to create solidarities between different kinds of unions which are emerging, and somewhere that connection does not happen. Domestic work unions remain separate from sex works union or the bar girls union, but the fact is that we are all talking about the same thing. We are talking about the value of women's work and the dignity of women's work. So somewhere those connections need to be made, and we need to emerge, have built solidarities among those unions. The second thing that I've been hearing since yesterday and what I've heard today as well in the morning in this panel is that we have to go back to the basics. We have to go back to the core fundamental principles and rights which should be available to all workers irrespective of what kind of workers they are, whether they're contract workers, regular workers, daily wage workers. The basic and the minimum needs to be ensured, and somewhere when we talk about bigger things, we lose that focus on the core fundamental issues that we have to be all together on. And that's something that all the trade unions, workers' rights organization and academia, I think, are unified. We have the same view that these need to be honored and respected. Third thing that I want to say in terms of moving forward is to look at newer forms of organizing. We've been hearing that the nature of work, the world of work is changing, gig economy is coming in. The way employer-employee relationship used to exist earlier is now changing. If those are the situations, then how do we as trade unions or we as workers' rights organization adapt to that change? How do we change our own organizing strategies, mobilizing strategies to keep in pace with the changing nature of work? Another thing that I want to quickly flag is that I come from a pharmaceutical background. My basic education is in pharmacy. But I was never taught anything about labor laws. I was never taught how to be a good entrepreneur, how to run a factory which is good, where it will have healthy workforce. And that, I think, is a big issue that our education system never teaches about labor issues. The only people who know a little bit about labor issues are the lawyers, you know, because they get trained in labor law. But how many of us actually take labor law? I'm a lawyer as well. I did take up labor law because I was very influenced by my father, but not many of my friends really, they wanted to go into the corporate sector world. So they were thinking from a different hat, and there were very few people within our class who were thinking from the other side. So the question is, how do we expand the issue of labor to all the other domains, all the technical education, whether they are engineers, doctors, lawyers, how do they look at the issue of labor? That is totally sort of never taught. It is never taught in schools, and work is central to all of us. Last thing that I just want to say is this kind of workshop was important. Most of us are doing wonderful work, but we don't get to see what others are doing. We are not able to make those connections and keep working in those silos. As Igor also mentioned, that this kind of opportunity is unique because here we get a mix of different kinds of people and look at different kinds of perspectives. And these kind of forums are, I think, very, very essential to take forward the labor movement. And we need to have more of these bridging silos kind of workshops. The last is how do we use technology? The world of work is changing. You know, we heard Ola, we heard Uber. They're using technology to aggregate workers. Are we as trade unions, as we as workers organizations, up, you know, tuned to technology? Can we use technology? We do have some examples where the trade unions have started using technology, and it has been wonderful in organizing workers. So that's my last thing, that, you know, let's be open to technology. If the employers and if artificial intelligence is coming in, let's see how we can use that intelligence to actually further our cause. So that's my last point.